Hello everyone, I hope you're doing well. Welcome to Peaches' Kitchen. Today, I'm going to show you how to make sorrel. Okay, let us begin. Please get a large pot and we're going to fill the pot with 3 jugs of water. What happened there, I realized that, okay, it wasn't enough. So I did about half more of water. So 3.5 jugs of water. Once you've got the amount of water that's required, put it on the stove. Don't want the fire too high, just to let the water boil. This is the amount of ginger you will need. At least 2 small bags of ginger. Here, I am cutting off the bad bits of the ginger. Be careful when you're using a knife in the kitchen, please. See, I'm showing you all the bad bits. I'm just cutting them off. We don't want that in our sorrel. Take the ginger over to the sink and just scrub it clean of all dirt that may be on the ginger. Now you get your sorrel. Pour it into your colander. We're going to wash it. But before we wash the sorrel, what I'm going to do is to check that there are no bad flowers in the sorrel. Any bad bits, I will take it out. And this is what I'm doing. I'm just checking. And as you can see, I've taken something out that shouldn't be in there. Okay? Anything that doesn't look correct, just take it out of the sorrel. And this is your sorrel. The sorrel is dry. Okay, like how you'll dry petals, flower petals. So the sorrel is dry. So just check in for any bad bits. Once you check for any bad bits, we're just rinsing the sorrel in cold water. Your next stage is to grate the ginger. One thing I must say, be careful when you're using the ginger. I am quick, but if you haven't used the ginger before, go slowly. Yeah, and also what you need to do is not to put the ginger in a blender and blend it, grate it. And the reason why you would grate the ginger is because, you know, you get that full benefit when you're ready to do the next stage. Once you finished grating your ginger, check the water in the pot if it is boiling. If it isn't boiling, then turn the fire up so that you can see the water bubbling. Then you know it is boiling. Here, I'm going to add a stick of cinnamon to the boiling water in the pot. And we add the cinnamon just to give it extra flavoring. Now I'm adding the sorrel that I've washed earlier on to the pot of boiling water. Be careful you don't get any splashes of hot water on your hand or in your face. We are just stirring the sorrel. Now add your ginger to the sorrel. And again, give it a stir. You will notice that it isn't boiling, it isn't bubbling, as I would say, and you haven't seen the color changing yet, but just give it a few seconds and let the pot boil. As you can see, there are the bubbles are coming up very slowly. Okay, now you've got more bubbles, and as you can notice, the color of the water is changing. Okay, just keep giving it a stir, and as you can see, the color is more deeper. And yes, can we see it is boiling? Okay, once you've got that bubble, and it is, you can turn off the fire under your pot. Give it another stir. much deeper red now. So your sorrel is ready. Here we cover the pot of sorrel and ginger and cinnamon to draw for at least 2 days. After 2 days, your sorrel is ready. Now give it another stir just to wake up all those flavors of the ginger, the sorrel, and the cinnamon. Now I am straining the sorrel and the ginger petals into a sieve. And the reason why I'm doing this is because I don't want any bits of ginger or sorrel into the liquid or the cinnamon stick. Here, I'm just using the back of the spoon just to squeeze out the liquid from the sorrel and the ginger. You can use your hand if you prefer, but I just don't want to get the color on my hand, so I just use the spoon, the wooden spoon. Once you've done that, just put this aside in another bowl or a dish. What I'm doing here is to strain the sorrel again, just to make sure there's no further bits in the liquid. As you can see, that's the bits that I'm trying not to have in the liquid. Just wash the container and the sieve out, and then do another straining to make sure finally there isn't any more bits that you can see. Okay? And that's what I'm doing. Okay? Get your brown sugar. You could use white if you prefer, but I prefer to use brown. We pour this into the container with the sorrel, and we're doing this to sweeten. We're sweetening the sorrel to your desired taste. So what I'm doing is to sweeten, I'm sweetening the sorrel. And this will take a little bit of time. As you can see, I'm tasting to see if it is sweet enough. It isn't, so I'm going to pour some more of the brown sugar into the liquid. Continue to stir until all the sugar is dissolved. Taste it again. Now get your lemon. Cut your lemon into half and use your juicer to squeeze all the juice from the lemon. Once that's ready, we're going to strain. Use your strainer to strain this into the sorrel. You just need one lemon. Just get all the juice from the lemon into your sorrel. Okay, we don't want all the lemon pulp. Now you're just stirring it to get all those flavors. Once again, taste it and see if you need any more sugar, or it is okay. Yeah, it is okay. So I'm happy. No more sugar. Now you can bottle your sorrel. What I've done, I'm showing you that if you do not drink alcohol, you do not need to put any alcohol in it. Once you've put the lemon in, just pour this into bottles, glass bottles, ready for your fridge. For those who would like to put some alcohol, in there, we put a small shot of white rum into the sorrel. And at least two shots of red label wine. As you can see, I put one first to try to see how sweet it would be, and I'm going to give my daughter to taste to see if it's if it does have enough. It wasn't enough to her taste, so I'm adding another shot of the red label wine. So what I've done, I've had one shot of the white rum and two shots of the red label wine. I've given it to my daughter a second time so she can taste it. And now she said it was okay. So now you're ready to bottle the alcohol version of the sorrel. Now, your sorrel is now ready to be put in your fridge for you to enjoy. This is your sorrel with the alcohol in it. You've noticed I've put less ice. This is the one with the no alcohol, just the lemon, just the added lemon. Okay, enjoy your sorrel. I hope you will make it. Have a good drink. And this is what we do for Christmas, birthdays, or Easter. Thank you for watching.